representing portions of Cuyahoga and Lake Counties. I've been in the Senate since the latter part of 2008. I was a Cleveland City Councilwoman before that, so I certainly understand the importance of local government to make a difference in the lives of people. I'm a native Clevelander, born and raised there. I'm married, I have a son, and I am just, you know, a pro-voter person. I believe that the Secretary of State's job is to expand and protect access to the ballot box, and unfortunately, in my opinion, that has not been happening in the great state of Ohio. By way of my other profession, I'm also a professor at Cuyahoga Community College. And speaking of college, I am a first-generation college graduate, so I certainly understand the power of education to help one change the trajectory of their life. And so I'm really glad to be here with that. Oh, just one other thing I wanted to add to, Mark, is that I worked for Mayor Michael R. White, so I've been, you know, in a cabinet. I've been an administrator in the city of Cleveland, and I also was the director of government affairs for the Cleveland Municipal School District for a time as well, and was really there when first No Child Left Behind was being implemented. It was my job to make sure that we got that implemented throughout the district. So I believe that voting should be simple, should be convenient, and it should be accessible, and that is the job of the Secretary of State, and that is why I'm running.
You have the election side of that office and the business side of that office. Can you give us some ideas of some policy proposals you would be bringing in and wanting to implement?
Yes. On the election side, I certainly believe right now that the Secretary of State has the capacity to allow people to register online. I don't necessarily think, I think the same code that gives the authority to allow people to correct their addresses is also the same authority that can be used to allow people to register online right now. Unfortunately, the legislature, of which I am a member of right now, has not taken that up. There is some bipartisan support for that, and it's unfortunate that the legislature is not taking that up, but it would be efficient. It would save time for both the elections professionals, but also the person that is registering. It makes it more broad, and it saves taxpayers' dollars. That's very important. As well as, I believe that we should pre-register 16 and 17-year-olds. I do have legislation pending right now, which I haven't had a hearing on as of yet, to pre-register 16 and 17-year-olds. I mean, we complain a lot, and as well we should. We should be concerned. I wouldn't necessarily call it a complaint that lots of people don't necessarily participate as much as we would like them to. We had a 17% voter turnout in this last primary. I firmly believe that if we start to catch young people a lot earlier, the stronger likelihood that they will be voters throughout their lifetime, that they will also be more engaged citizens, and that benefits all of us, that the democracy is a lot stronger the more people who participate. On the business side of the ledger, which does not get a lot of attention, has not gotten a lot of attention as of late, I really do believe that the business services side of the Secretary of State can do more than just be the place where all businesses register. Pretty much that's all that happens. So from the entrepreneur business to a seasoned corporation, they just file paperwork and that is it. And the Secretary of State will give a report on the record number of business filings, which is a wonderful thing. But I think we can take that a step further. In our state, we have not recovered necessarily from the Great Recession, and that we're still a little over 100,000 jobs down from where we were before. Since all businesses register through the Secretary of State's office, I think that office can be a bridge to help businesses, especially entrepreneur and very small businesses, in terms of linking them to financing, linking them to trade organizations. Another idea that I have is to have non-traditional business hours in the business services division for businesses that may need to talk to someone so they can open up really early or be open on the weekend or in the evening, so that if you have a question, you can ask a question, or if you want to chat online, you can do that again. Do that too, so that we are creating opportunities for people both in business, at the ballot box, and in life.